with a civilian death count well above 1,000. Throngs of locals are fleeing the fighting in eastern Ukraine. At least a third of the refugees are children. International monitors that have witnessed the evacuation say it's far from safe, even for cars that are clearly marked.
We did notice a flow of civilians. We noticed, for example, families in their cars, they had the word in Russian, "Dete," children, taped onto the windows to indicate that there were children in their car. So there's definitely a sense of, I would say, almost panic. The explosions that we heard when we decided to turn back were very, very loud.
RT's Roman Koshrev met with some of those who've crossed over to Russia and are hoping to get a fresh start away from the violence.
Yevdokia was 12 years old when the Second World War began, and the grandmother remembers that time vividly. But she probably never imagined that 73 years later, she would once again be hiding from airstrikes in her own backyard.
They have been bombing us, and they are still doing it now. The jets fly very low. You can hear them firing in the morning and in the evening.
This camp's been operating since mid-June. Displaced people find shelter here for a few days and then move on to places more suitable for longer-term living. The latest arrivals came from the shell-shocked town of Lugansk.
I couldn't sleep during my first night here. Before I left, I said goodbye to my sister and gave her the paperwork so that she could have my flat.
Yelena says she's lost everything as the result of Kiev's military action. Her only hope for a fresh start now is in the Siberian city of Novosibirsk, where she has relatives.
We never thought something like this could happen. I was getting a pension and was still working. Now I've lost my job, my house and my pension.
At least a third of the refugees are children, and Russian humanitarian authorities try to provide what they can to make their time here as comfortable as possible. But no matter the effort, such conditions are certainly not normal for these youngsters.
This refugee camp that can hold up to 500 people is just a kilometer away from the border, which frequently comes under artillery fire from Ukraine. The people I've talked to here now want nothing to do with their former country. For some, the last straw was constant shelling and gunfire that forced them to practically live in basements or bomb shelters. For others, the sight of friends and relatives killed by multiple rocket strikes. Roman Kosarev, RT, Russia-Ukrainian border.